In this video, we will talk about the principle of pH calibration. Thanks for all the likes on our videos. Your support is the greatest power for us to make more videos. The last video explained how a pH meter converts the concentration of hydrogen ions to the voltage signal and outputs it to devices like main controllers through amplifier. And we learned that, in fact, the sensed concentration change is the potential change on the outer glass electrode. It turns out there is a linear relationship between millivolt signals and pH values. With pH values as the abscissa, x-axis, and millivolt values as the ordinate, y-axis, at 25 degrees Celsius, we can plot a pH versus millivolt curve graph on which the millivolt value ranges from negative 414 to 414, and it equals 0 millivolts when the pH is 7. Well, it's just an ideal curve. In reality, no pH sensor can reach the theoretical voltages. So we need to use the buffer solutions with known concentrations to calibrate it. As noted above, the theoretical potential at pH 7 is 0 millivolts, but actually the potential is usually between negative 47 and 47 millivolts because of zero drift and asymmetric potential. Zero drift is caused by electrode aging and manufacturing uncertainties, and the asymmetric potential is generated by the thickness difference between the internal and external gel layers of the glass electrode. The inner gel layer generally remains relatively intact because it is protected by the structure inside during its entire service life, while during storage, the external gel layer will be drier and thinner due to chemical attack from the tested solution, which gradually leads to a thickness difference. Generally, a relatively new electrode just requires one-point calibration to work properly. Calibration will help both find the zero point and compensate for the changes in the curve slope. In theory, the voltage changes by 59.16 millivolts per pH unit at 25 degrees Celsius according to the Nernst equation, and there are 6 units between pH 1 and pH 7, so the voltage at pH 1 is 355 millivolts. But in actual use, a pH sensor cannot produce the potential change of 59.16 millivolts per unit because as the electrode ages, its sensitivity decreases. Normally, if a pH sensor's output reaches 85% of that in an ideal case, it is considered to be usable. Otherwise, the sensor probe needs to be replaced. Immerse the probe into the proven buffer solutions. For example, the pH 7 and pH 4 standard solutions. Get the voltage reading at pH 7 and mark it in the graph. Get the reading at pH 4 and mark it. Connect the two points with a straight line and extend it. Then a pH versus millivolt curve is done. For daily use, DFRobot provides the relevant open-source software library, which helps automatically identify the standard buffer solutions and perform two-point calibration quickly. The chemical corrosion, rinsing, and wiping against the glass electrode will lead to changes in the gel layer thickness and electrode's potentials. Therefore, we should maintain the sensor accuracy through calibration for obtaining more precise data. Besides, temperature also affects pH measurements. The readings above are all obtained at 25 degrees Celsius. As we all know about batteries, the higher the temperature, the higher the voltage. Conversely, if the temperature is low, the voltage output is not as high as expected. Since temperature will affect the slope of the pH calibration curve, its impact on pH readings should be taken into account if the measurements are done at different ambient temperatures. It is best to use standard solutions with the same temperature as the solutions to be tested during calibration. So how often do you need to replace electrodes? Well, according to our experience, it depends on your actual use conditions. Our laboratory electrodes are usually replaced after operating 6 months in the normal service condition. Please note that pH electrodes are fragile and need to be handled with care. Well, that's all about pH calibration. There are some relevant documents in the top comment for your reference. What else are you interested in? Tell us in the comments. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please subscribe, like, and comment for us.